Interesting. You said success and fame and the change in the way other people perceived me hadn't erased whatever was wrong behind the mask. I had reached what I was after, and it wasn't the answer. Whatever was missing was still missing. So through all the things that you, all the success, all the lights, all the crowds, all the money, all the albums sold, and something is still missing.
Yeah, you know, when we leave the spotlight, at some point during the day, we have to look in the mirror.
Yeah.
And we have to either like ourselves or not like ourselves. And my journey was one to turn my life around. And I couldn't write a book like this unless it had a happy ending. I've got an amazing wife. We just celebrated our 9th anniversary. We've been together 13 years. I've got 4 amazing children. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I'd like to inspire people to roll up your sleeves and make your life everything it can be, because you deserve to have an amazing life. And,
right.
And it's within every one of us to have it.
Absolutely. You write that Phantom of the Opera changed your life. How so?
When I saw Phantom of the Opera in London in 1988, I watched it and I went, I can do that. And I had no background in that. 10 years later, I got a call at CAA, my talent agents, and they said, how do you feel about trying to do a musical? And I said, well, what is it? And they said, Phantom of the Opera. You'd have to go do a full-on audition in New York. And I said, I'm in. So I went to New York, got the role, and they flew me up to Toronto, where the show had run for 10 years. And I took mm-hmm. over, doing 8 shows a week there. And I suddenly realized that, in many ways, the Phantom was me. It was a story of a scarred, deformed musician who hid behind a mask. Wow, I didn't even see that. Mm-hmm. And was looking for love and couldn't give it back, even though he wanted it.
Right.
So it was a turning point for me, and it was eye-opening. And it also perhaps coincided with a change in my life, ending a marriage that really perhaps was never meant to be, mm-hmm. but I got a wonderful son out of it. So, you know.
What are you like as a dad?
I'm a...
Like, do your kids, like, get into... Do they know who their father is?
They think dad's pretty cool, you know?
I think so.
You know, I drive them to school, and, you know, you lead...
This is the picture we show.
There's me.
Like
there's...
that?
That's them at my office.
Exactly.
But, you know, if you're a great parent, you lead by example. It's not about what you say, it's about what you do.
You know,
because your kids are going to grow up, and they'll know when you lied to them and when you didn't tell them exactly what was going on. And I've tried to live a life that I don't have to make apologies or excuses for, because my kids... You know, life starts off for children as a blank slate. We write on it whatever we want. So mm-hmm. that's our duty and our obligation, is when we leave the world, to leave it a better place by leaving children who are better than we are.
Absolutely. Paul's incredible book is called Face the Music, A Life Exposed. It's in bookstores now. And I'm so excited that you came here today, brother. Thank you so much.